jandals, flip-flops, blockies. We will never have world peace unless we can agree on a name for these shoes. Nowhere where you go in the world are they called the same. You could get on a plane right now, fly somewhere you've never been before, get off, go to a shop and go, excuse me, I'm looking for those summer shoes that you can get your toes through like that. And then, oh, you're talking. We don't even question why the f*** it's called that. We just go, yeah, I was hoping to buy some blue.
Would you welcome Urzila Carlson?
Sorry, what?
Sorry, we're in the middle of discussing social networks.
Yeah, right. You know, Kate, you saw a movie and you believed it was the real thing.
But guess what, Urzila Carlson?
No, we've just been told in our ear.
Yeah.
Timberlake in 2011 did buy MySpace.
Or did he invest in MySpace?
Did he invest or buy it? Guys,
come on.
He jointly purchased the company for $35 million.
But you know. Yeah, he didn't buy it because he thought there was a sure thing. He bought it to get some of his nudes off. That's the only thing. And thank God he did. That's the only way I got my stuff off.
Can we go back, by the way?
What, taking nudes?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm of an age now when I send it, people go, did you mean to send this to you? You know, when you get to an age where you take nudes, you go, whoever's touching that is doing God's work.
Sometimes you just can't get a good angle.
Yeah, my eyes, like just, my eyes are getting shorter. Well, maybe we should help each other.
Oh, hello.
There's a business in that. Maybe JT should invest in that. Yeah. Hey, can we go back to talking about thongs, which is also part of that investment, I'm sure. The thongs on your feet, though. What do you call thongs these days?
Well, I mean, you know, I call them pluckies or jandals.
Yeah. Pluckies?
Yeah. In South Africa, we call them pluckies. But, you know, we're getting into summer season. It's so dangerous. You know, there's so much moisture around now with global warming. So you've got to be careful. Make sure your hooves are tidy. No one wants to see your nails growing over the front. No one wants to see your tap dancer following them down the footpath. You know, so make sure your hooves are tidy and you avoid moisture at all times.
Did you pack some for this trip?
No. You know, I'm a sporty lady myself. I like to be ready to run, so I'm always a runner. No, and also I've got a side hustle. I'm signing a lot of Elton John microphones. Yeah. Those things are heavy. If you drop that on an open foot, you
know. So you hear about your brand new tour.
Yes.
Which is a wonderful name, Just No.
Yeah.
What exactly are you saying?
Look,
no
I can
to?
Say no to a lot of things. We're fatigued of each other. We're fatigued of, you know, bad news. We're fatigued of people squeezing in front of you in the line. We're fatigued of a lot of stuff. People bidding against you that, you know, look, I'm going to be the last one. They know it, but they still go for it.
Yeah.
So,
just and no also, to nudes, you know?
Oh, no, I mean, be open to that. if you
maybe,
ask for it, don't
maybe.
Then. Yeah, but, you know, like just stuff and stuff that has happened in my life that I thought in the past, I thought I need to keep that bottled up. But now I'm like, no, I'm going to share that with the world because it's a lot cheaper than therapy. You know, stuff has happened to me in my life. I once accidentally kissed an elderly lady right on her dentures. You know, and it's one of those things that's a core memory. I know. Right.
I'm just focusing on the word accidentally.
I know. You know when... Okay, yeah, like
was
we've all...
accidentally?
No, we've all had those. It's the way you're at the school fundraiser and you go to hug a dad or maybe give him a side cheek and he turns and you kiss him in the neck or you know, and all of a sudden you're in a relationship or... So this is the same. Like, I was at a party. I tried to say goodbye, so I was kissing this auntie on her cheek and she turned to say one more thing but then exposed the upper and the lower dentures and I kissed her with both my lips on the dentures and I always think about that sensation.
Right.
Those cold, dead teeth.
And are you in a relationship now?
I'm married her. I made an honest lady out of her. You know, she's not a hoe bag, so there we go.
You have been in Oz for a short time, but from your socials, it looks like you're up to no good. What's going on here? Let's have a look. So this is...
Yeah.
What
is called, this is your basic urban harvesting.
What are you doing?
I'm picking avocados. It's
unbelievable.
I got a stick. I found a stick. There goes the avocado, and that's me. See where the runners? Now I'm running across the road.
Look at
that. Look at that. There's a backpack full of microphones, and then I'm going to come back. Yeah, I was just picking...
It's an avocado on the... growing in a yard so in Melbourne.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But that, as you can see, it didn't break any rules. No laws were,
hanging over.
Yeah, I had to reverse the car, climb on the roof, and then climb sort of halfway over and get the rest of them. But
did you have to wait like a year for it to ripen, though? It was
green. No, just chuck them with the bananas. They'll be right in no time. Because you don't want to leave those in the supermarket because people squeeze them.
Yeah,
you know?
That's
like,
true.
Then
yeah.
They just
yeah, you'd
diseased.
Much rather beat it with a stick first.
Yeah, honestly, I can't do more damage than a housewife.
Well, head to our website for all the details on Urzila's Just Say No Aussie Tour, which kicks off in March next year. Always a pleasure. Urzila Carlson.